to the life and ministry of Christ, like, you know, where he laid his head at night, different things like that. The percent spoken by Christ is 42%, 36 quotations from the Old Testament, 59% unique material. And then we go to Luke, who was a physician and much more of a historian. And so we find that the book of Luke has a lot of kind of details that you wouldn't find. We normally read like the birth of Christ from the book of Luke because it's so detailed in comparison to Matthew or Mark. He was writing to the Greeks, demonstrating that Christ was the Son of God. It has numerous parables, that's its outstanding feature, has chronological arrangement, historical tone, and 50% spoken by Christ, and only 7% of it is unique material. So basically, only 7% of the book of Luke is only found in the book of Luke. So 93% of the book of Luke is found in the other gospels. So you can see how he was taking these and then kind of expanding on them. And then lastly is the book of John, which kind of defies everything, talking about Christ being the Son of God and how he was deity. And his audience was really for everyone. The key words are believe, the outstanding feature is teachings, it's very topical, and the tone is spiritual. John says a lot of things that are spiritual, like abide in me, or I am the true vine and ye are the branches, things that are kind of like a little bit more abstract, but helping us recognize that this is a spiritual journey that we're on. 50% was spoken by Christ. There's 105 allusions to the Old Testament, and 93% is unique material. So there's just some really great things to pick out. So even like if you're starting to speak on sermons and you have a sermon that has a historical background and you're talking about the life of Christ, you're probably going to go to Luke to find some of your scripture. Say you're speaking about the oneness of God or about our spiritual journey and how Christ reflects this our spirituality today, you're going to go to the book of John probably to find some of these scriptures. So the last one we'll talk about is just the book of Revelation, which we know is at the very end. And John is, again, speaking in some prophecy. So we see that's where he is writing to the seven churches. He's speaking about the end time. And one thing about the book of Revelation that's really important, the Bible says that there's no other book that you will be blessed just by reading it. So in Revelation chapter 1, so this is after all the epistles have been read or gone through. In Revelation chapter 1, verse C, it says, "Blessed is he that readeth, and they that hear the words of this prophecy, and keep those things which are written therein, for the time is at hand." I think it's so amazing because in Galatians 4:4, we're talking about the fullness of time. Right now, we are in preparation because the fullness of time for the coming judgment of God is upon us. It is coming. And things are taking place around the world that are preparing this day to come. And so here he says, you will be blessed just by reading and hearing the words of Revelation. So one minister recommended that it is good to listen to the book of Revelation out loud. So it's not necessarily... you can certainly read it on its own, but it's definitely also meant to be heard. So when you get a chance, when you want to read something from the Bible or you want to listen to something, the Bible says that you will be blessed just by hearing the words of the prophecy of the book of Revelation, and it has so much relevance to the day and age that we're living in. I don't spend a lot of time studying prophecy because, Yeah, there is a lot to it, and I think some of it is definitely worth knowing, but then there's some things I don't know if we're intended to know until they happen. I think it's also just a preference. If you enjoy studying prophecy, then the book of Revelation has so much prophecy in it for the day and age that we're living in. So that is the all of the New Testament that we're going to go over today. We could spend, again, so much time on the New Testament, but that's a basic overview and what we can learn from it. And then building up from all the previous classes that we had, it's just a perfect fulfillment of everything that we've learned up to this point. Do you have any questions about any of the assignments or... anything that we went over today, I'm going to turn this back up. Any questions? Are you doing okay, Maria? You're good? Okay, awesome. So I've gotten, if you haven't gotten everything turned in, feel free to send me an email. I will have April recordings to you later today. We just got them uploaded, so if you do want to go over anything from your previous classes. The next class, which will start at, 11 o'clock, is that right?
11:15.
At 11:15, thank you, Brother Charlie. At 11:15, that'll be the test for Sister Vicky's class on the life of Christ. And that is, again, open note and open book. Were you aware of that, Maria? You weren't aware of the test? Okay. I was just saying beforehand that I didn't get the test till quite late, so I'm going to email it to you at the beginning of class. Will that work okay? Just send it via email?
You might have to send it by Andrew.
Okay. Okay, I'll go ahead and send it to Brother Andrew and to yourself. If you, like, say, for example, you don't get it within that time period, you can always return it to me later. That's fine.
Right.
Or to Sister Vicky. You can send it to Sister Vicky via email.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, no problem. So I'll make sure to send that at the beginning of the next hour. You have a question? Oh. But up until that, you have a few minutes and a break until 11:15, and then we'll get started on Life of Christ. All right. Thank you so much for being attentive, and I will see you next month. We will have the Bible survey exam. Sometime during this month, I'll probably send you an email with just a few things to make sure you study for. That way you're prepared for what's going to be on the test. Just so we have an idea. Okay. God bless you, and I will see you probably throughout the day.